NASA's Voyager spacecraft are traveling on an escape trajectory from the Sun and are now on a journey that will take them through the outer reaches of the solar system and out into the Milky Way galaxy. They carry on board the Golden Records, a message from all humankind out into the cosmos. In the thousands, millions, and even billions of years of travel, where will they go? What will they see? Who might find them and learn about us long after we're gone? At the time I'm recording this video, NASA's twin Voyager spacecraft are still fully operational, flying away from the solar system. Voyager 1 was launched on September 5th, 1977, and has now reached a distance of 144 astronomical units, or 144 times the distance from the Earth to the Sun. Light takes over 20 hours to travel from the spacecraft to Earth, and its velocity compared to the Sun is more than 61,000 kilometers per hour. Voyager 1 is on an escape trajectory, and it's never coming back. Voyager 2 was launched on August 20th, 1977. Because of a longer journey that took it past Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, it hasn't made the same distance. It's only 120 astronomical units from Earth. Light merely takes 16 hours and 40 minutes to reach us. Its velocity is a slower 55,000 kilometers per hour. And Voyager 2 is also on an escape trajectory, charting a different path through the Milky Way. What does the future hold for these spacecraft? The immediate answer, of course, is death. Both spacecraft use radioisotope thermoelectric generators, batteries that convert the heat from decaying chunks of plutonium into electricity. It's astounding to realize that they've already lasted over 40 years, but they're closer to the end of their lives than the beginning. When they launched, the Voyagers enjoyed 470 watts of sweet electrical power, but as the plutonium-238 decays, they're down to about 249 watts. Each drop in power means that NASA needs to turn off more and more of their science instruments. And then, sometime in the 2020s or 2030s, the power levels will get so low that their transmitters will fail and will mark the moment we heard the last message from the far-flung Voyagers. Their momentum will carry them onward and outward into the Milky Way. But where? Astronomers Corin Baylor-Jones and David Farnocchia calculated the future paths of the Voyagers and calculated what stars they'll encounter along their journey. They made these calculations using the second data release from the European Space Agency's Gaia spacecraft. This is the spacecraft that's carefully calculating the location of 1% of the stars in the entire Milky Way. I've done a whole video celebrating this data release and warned you that it would come up time and time again in fascinating ways, and this is one of them. In addition to charting the location to more than a billion stars, Gaia is measuring the 3D velocities of 7.2 million nearby stars. In other words, Gaia tells us how all the stars around us are moving over the near future, and the researchers looked at the paths the Voyagers will take over the upcoming tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, and millions of years. In about 16,700 years, Voyager 1 will make its closest flyby of Proxima Centauri, the closest star to the Sun. From our perspective, Proxima Centauri is 4.2 light years away, and Voyager 1 will only get a little closer, 3.5 light years. Proxima Centauri is a smaller red dwarf star, and it's known to have at least one planet in the habitable zone. But at 3.5 light years away, Voyager 1 wouldn't be able to get much of a better view. Also, it would have been stone cold dead for tens of thousands of years. Voyager 2 is going in roughly the same direction, and will cross its closest point at 20,300 years, getting within 2.87 light years of Proxima Centauri. Assuming it doesn't meet up with an alien probe and return to Earth as V'ger at the 42,000 year mark, Voyager 2 gets within 1.6 light years of Ross 248. This is a dim red dwarf star with only 12% the mass of the Sun. And according to science fiction author Alistair Reynolds, Ross 248 has an ice planet called Diadem with ice worms that have turned the entire planet into a thinking consciousness. Voyager 2 won't be able to confirm Reynolds' ice worm thinking planet hypothesis because it'll be dead, long dead. Then Voyager 1 gets within 1.86 light years of Gliese 445 on year 44,000 of its long journey. To be honest, it's really Gliese 445 that's doing the heavy lifting here. This main sequence star is hurtling in our direction. It's 17.6 light years away today, but when Voyager makes its flyby, it'll be about 3.45 light years from us. And on that day, a person with perfect vision, with the darkest, least light-polluted skies, could just barely see that star in the sky. But Voyager 1 could see it if it wasn't dead, which it will be 44,000 years from now. More thrilling adventures await the Voyagers and even the Pioneer spacecraft, and we'll get to them in a second, but first I'd like to thank Pump and Hold, Joel Adams, Eric Herman, Miguel, Andre Johansson, and the rest of our 801 patrons for their generous support. They contribute so that you can see these videos and we can make them freely available to anyone who wants to learn about space. Join our community at patreon.com/universetoday and get in on the action. I'll spare you the play-by-play flybys of the missions. Just know that at some point in the next 3.4 million years or so, Voyager 1 will get as close as 1.27 light years away from a star known only by a series of numbers. Voyager 2 will make a similar flyby to a different star with a different string of numbers in 2.2 million years from now, getting within 1.83 light years. Baylor Jones and Farnochia plotted out the journeys of NASA's Pioneer spacecraft 2. Pioneer 10 and 11 are on escape trajectories from the solar system, and they'll also see a close flyby of Ross 248, Proxima Centauri, and Gliese 445. And 90,000 years from now, Pioneer 10 will get within 3/4 of a light year of HIP 117795, an orange-red star in the constellation Cassiopeia. Beyond that, the future is hazy. With future Gaia surveys, we could see more accurate predictions of where the probes will be over the tens of millions, hundreds of millions, and even billions of years of flight. They'll inevitably come closer to other stars in their journeys. How long will the Voyagers last? Their golden records have been placed face down on the spacecraft, and according to Cosmos, they should still be playable in a billion years from now. Long enough for the spacecraft to complete 4 orbits around the Milky Way and encounter many stars. These calculations are, of course, nothing more than entertainment to spark our imaginations. The distances between stars are vast, and the fastest spacecraft ever sent by humanity will still need tens of thousands of years to cross them. Until then, we'll work on faster and faster techniques for reaching other stars, and maybe someday we'll send a future mission that will zip past the Voyagers and travelers can see them out the windows, thinking back to the first times that humanity reached out beyond the solar system. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Once a week, I gather up all my space news into a single email newsletter and send it out. It's got pictures, brief highlights about the story, and links so that you can find out more. Go to universetoday.com/newsletter to sign up. And did you know that all of my videos are also available in a handy audio podcast format so that you can have the latest episodes show up right on your audio device? Go to universetoday.com/audio or search for Universe Today on iTunes, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts, and I'll put a link in the show notes. And finally, here's a playlist.